So itulah. So today I nak ajar a bit of my own framework, the way I tackle heavy topic ke, new concept ke, new skills or anything in between. So this is the hack, the way that I do so far. So we call it as accelerated learning. So typically learning punya curve ataupun learning punya approach selalu quite linear kan. Kita belajar kat sekolah, by chapters ke, by book ke, anything ke. So it's quite linear. To me it's boring. It's too slow. And then our brain, dia tak suka benda-benda slow ni. Bila dia slow, dia boring, dia cepat bosan, dia reject benda tu. So that's it lah. So kita tak belajar apa-apa. So I suka benda ni kan. So let me start with this. Anyone can tell what is this? So this is superheroes lah, some of them. So superheroes, why we call it superheroes? Because they have superpowers. Again, some of them. So kat dalam gambar ni ada yang tak ada superpowers, but dia ada something else extra lah. So maybe dia ada super resource ke, and then maybe dia ada knowledge ke, dia kan. For example like Batman, so dia tak takut. So yeah, superpowers ada banyak kan. Macam for example like Superman dia hobi dia fly. So time ni dia ada super strength, dia ada super sonic. Apa lagi jat? Superpower Superman banyak kan. Dia kebal. And then so macam The Flash, dia lari laju. So sebabkan dia sangat laju, lagi laju daripada cahaya, daripada bunyi, so dia boleh buat banyak benda lah, sampai dia boleh pusing masa because of the relativity of time, everything kan, physics. This is a law of physics lah. But I don't want to highlight this, so I just use this as a representative to highlight about superpower. Okay. So dalam banyak-banyak superpower kan, korang rasa, if you guys or girls got the chance to pick one superpower, what kind of superpower would like you have? Anyone?
Terbang.
Terbang? Oh, that's a good one. Terbang tak bayar banyak tol, tak payah beli kereta kan. Laju pula tu. Ika, what kind of superpower would like to have? Maybe mind reading?
True, you read my mind.
Oh, fantastic. Maybe, Koyum, what kind of superpower would like you have?
Saya tak sure sebab tak layan pun
cerita
situ jenis.
Oh, Isa. Amani?
Terbang, layan laju, semua nak.
Semua nak? Okay, tamak ni. So, pilih satu je. Okay. Alright. For me, kalau diberi pilihan untuk pilih satu, superpower, I would like to have a super learning punya ability lah. So, me, this is the best superpower. Basically, when you have a super ability to learn faster, basically you can achieve almost everything in this world. You can learn quickly to make a business, create wealth, and then grow your business. You boleh jadi kaya. You can belajar buat spaceship, you boleh pergi Mars. You boleh belajar buat apps, boleh belajar cepat, you boleh fulfill your career. So there's so many things inside this. You boleh belajar biology to hack your biology untuk live practically forever ataupun longer. That's a, to me, is a super learning is a very cool thing lah to have. So let's talk about super learning. So super learning ada basically, kalau if you ask me, ada banyak. So one of the that I practice is a speed reading. So speed reading take time to acquire these skills. So if I recall correctly, I started to pick up speed reading punya book, the first book, I beli 2009 tau. And then masa tu boleh lah baca, oh tak ada masalah, 2-3 hari dah boleh speed read, tapi tak faham apa pun. So tak guna juga kan. Speed reading tu, baik-baik tak payah baca kan. So from there, I pick up, I refine, I polish the skills, lama-lama boleh faham, dia punya comprehension rate meningkat. tapi hanya boleh apply kepada bahasa sahaja. Bila when it comes to English, I cannot do that. So itu dululah, tapi sekarang English okay. And then lepas tu I gradually increase. Lepas tu technical punya books pun, textbooks pun I dah boleh dah speak read. So it take time to acquire certain skills. Sama lah dulu macam nak belajar membaca pun, belajar kenal huruf dulu, lepas tu belajar membaca, tu belajar sebut. Nak belajar bawa basikal pun sama. So everything take time. So right, the second thing is to me is the ability to deconstruct the skills ataupun that particular knowledge. So I selalu tekankan pasal the Pareto rules atau Pareto principles ataupun nama lain adalah 80-20 rules. So this 80-20 rules basically kita just spend 20% of the effort that contribute 80% of the impact. So actually ada dua orang budak maths sini kan. So dunia kita ni penuh dengan patterns tau, mathematical patterns. So it's everywhere. Last time I think I ada share pasal our wardrobe. So dalam tu ada baju, let's say ada 10 baju kan, ada shawl, baju apa semua. Tapi pusing-pusing ada, mesti ada favorite. Kita pakai baju sama je. So that's one thing. Another thing, business. So 80% of the sales selalunya datang daripada 20% of the repeat customer. Oh, I hear someone. Is it Dr. Kambi? Sekejap eh.
Salam, apa khabar semua?
Khabar baik, hi doktor. So we just started. How are you today, doc?
I'm fine, thank you for inviting me.
Oh, no problem. I guess this is our first together call with you. Itulah. So currently what we're doing right now is it's a sharing session lah. So we try to do this weekly basis. So every mid of the week, weekdays, so which is Rabu lah, we spend our lunch. So sambil-sambil makan, sambil-sambil having lunch, we share. So last week Amani's punya turn. So this week I pick up the mantle, so I going to present something. So today I present about speed learning ataupun super learning. So it's actually a framework, a method, approach that I use lah to pick up any skills, any knowledge in a faster way. So we just started, don't worry. So kita baru, I think baru third slide kot. First slide yang ada isi lah. So the first one is speed reading tadi. So to me speed reading is helpful lah. So to pick up the super learning ability. The second one is the Pareto rules 80-20. Tadi I dah bagi example about the wardrobe, about sales. Lepas tu pula another example macam kita belajar kat sekolah, kat universiti kan. So, for example like me lah, I study computer science kan. Kita belajar banyak benda, tapi actually when it come to workforce, bila dah masuk industri, kita sebenarnya kita tak practice semua pun. Actually kalau kira betul-betul plus minus 20% je of the knowledge that we acquire yang kita guna. So quite embarrassing lah that thing. So if you invest the eyes, the heart into this Pareto rule, so you can spot there's so many things in this world that you can deconstruct, and then you boleh tahu lah, you boleh spot that 20% tu yang mana yang you patut tahu, yang the rest tu tak payah tahu. You don't need to know everything pun, you don't need to know 100% of the things to keep it going kan. But slowly you pick up more along the way lah. So the third thing is perseverance. When it comes to study, memang nothing is comfortable. Bila you too comfortable, basically you don't learn much lah. So kat sini ada letak satu chart. So you can see comfort zone, which is you feel safe and everything is in control. You tak belajar apa-apa. So basically you kena grow yourself dia keluar daripada comfort zone lah. Comfort zone could be anything. Macam for example lah, belajar time baring tak masuk punya. So dia kena ada proper space, proper setting lah untuk belajar. So kita ada mood ke, music ke, kursi yang yang okay ke. For me, I have my own way lah. So I belajar buat kerja berdiri. So kat sini I tak nak ulas panjang-panjang, but I think you can clearly see. So daripada comfort zone, so you kena keluar, you kena conquer the fear zone. Lepas tu, bila you dah conquer the fear zone, you lebih berani, you can deal with the challenge and problems lah. And then peringkat tertinggi adalah growth zone. Basically, I selalu kat sini, the learning zone and growth zone, I selalu go back and forth. Most of the time, I feel that I'm a top of the world. Because when I learn something, so I rasa macam the satisfactory itu is there. And then I think that I am growing. So I love that. So it's a very fulfilling things to do. So another thing is, so I pick up this from a physicist, Richard Feynman. So Richard Feynman cakap one of the way for you to stick the knowledge that you just acquire is by teaching someone else. So for example, you pick up a very dense punya material. So you cuba ajar orang yang memang bukan bidang tu. So kalau you berjaya ajar, maknanya you boleh simplify, you boleh compress that thing, and then you boleh compatible to the audience, you boleh comfort dia. So I think sebab it require kefahaman yang agak cukup lah baru boleh ajar kan. So and then last thing is cuba belajar, pick up the things is by to understand, bukan memorize. The first thing is we are no longer in the university ataupun sekolah, so kita tak perlu nak memorize apa-apa pun. So belajar faham saja pun dah cukup, it's a good start. So ada lagi lepas ni, so let me move the next slide. Oh, sorry. So this is since the past 4 years, 5 years, 10 years, okay lah, the past 4 years, I've read hundreds of books, one book or two books daily. Time I think of peak performance, so that's a quite a satisfying experience for me. So for this session, so there's a few books that I recommend lah that shapes the way I'm thinking today, the way I conducting things, the way I'm making decision. So inilah. So I don't want to go deeply into this, but I think semua orang patut baca. Tapi saya tak kuasa. Tapi if you want to grow, this is a good book for you to start, for you to internalize the content of the book, and then to reinvent your brain lah. Okay. So yang paling saya suka pasal belajar, and then I think it's very impactful, is how to read a book. Imagine. Buku ajar macam mana untuk baca buku. It's quite funny lah. Tapi it's a very, very good book. So, ini saja je. So, this is my workplace, my study place masa dekat UK dulu lah. So, this is the cleanest workspace that I can find. So, kalau you nampak kat situ, I modified my place jadi standing table. Like I just said tadi, I love working standing sebab if I sit or my chair is too comfortable, dia untuk mengular, chances untuk mengular ataupun procrastinate sangat tinggi. So bila I buat kerja berdiri, dia laju sebab penat kot berdiri. So you don't waste much time lah. So of course, and then berdiri dia bagus untuk health. So gambar yang kat tepi ni, I think Aizat tahu kot, dia closely related. So, ni masa I dengan pack nak balik hantar barang, so kita tumpang barang sekali kan, Jad?
Yes.
So ini first batch yang I ship, I think 130 something buku, and then the following year I ship another 100 books. So buku ni walaupun banyak ada, banyak juga I tak baca, but you know, I just love collecting books. Alright, proficiency tips. So this is a little secret that I think is very, very powerful. like I mentioned earlier, always discount comfortability and convenience. To me, convenience is good, but too convenient never be good. So macam yang chat tadi, bila kita comfortable sangat kita tak belajar apa-apa, and then comfortable pun sama juga. And then the second thing you need to know, talent is a gift. I don't have talent. I have zero talent. Tapi I grew myself lah. I pick up skills. I sharp. So basically, to me, I consider myself as a sharper. So I sharp my own skills, tambah skill sets, and then I belajar balik and then improve. So benda-benda macam itulah. So talent is a gift. It's good if you have talent, but hard work is win every time. So hard work, talent can give you a lot of things, but hard work can bring you very far and high. And then next is our brain is a muscle, sama juga. So siapa-siapa kalau macam selalu pergi gym macam Maizat kan, so kita pergi gym, orang pergi gym every day, dia tak pergi sekali and then dia expect oh esok dah fit, dah berketul-ketul badan ke apa semua kan. So it's a repetitive, it's a repetition. Sama juga dengan otak. So awal-awal tu mungkin to pick up a book untuk habiskan satu minggu is a chore, is a task. So lama-lama is getting a breeze lah. So kalau you selalu bombard yourself with expose with a lot of information, benda tu you getting easier and easier by day, and then you akan absorb banyak. So essentially be like sponge. Jadi sponge, you absorb everything, and then lepas tu baru you being analytical. Yang mana yang you perlu simpan, yang mana you perlu practice, yang mana you buang. Sebab there's a lot of noise out there, so you need to be smart lah. Which information you should keep. And then last night I met Koyum in person, so I ada beritahu dia. So I like this one quote by Bruce Lee. So Bruce Lee said, "Be shapeless like water." So kalau air masuk dalam cup, dia jadi cup. Dia masuk dalam bowl, jadi bowl lah. So ikut shape. So what I'm trying to say here is, you need to be adaptive to any changing ni. So katakan kerja tu required to be like this, and then you become like that. And then katakan benda ni, you selalu guna cara ni, maybe you try to improvise and then optimize stuff. So katakanlah selalu Aizat selalu dia buat stick kan. So dia selalu pakai, dia ada 5 step. Tapi dia boleh study sebenarnya. What make a stick good stick is berapa benda je. So dia boleh fokus that 20% yang tadi tu. So bila fokus yang 20%, kadang-kadang tu it's not ingredient. Sebab bila kita buat stick macam hotel apa semua kan, hotel guna similar, kita guna similar ingredient with them, tapi kenapa tak sama? So ada benda lain lah maknanya. Maybe dari segi temperature, the working time, the prep is different. So benda-benda macam tu, it require a skill je lah. It take times to acquire that. And then bila dah dapat, you boleh deconstruct and pick up any knowledge or skills in no time. And then lastly, kita tahu macam air kan, air boleh buat lekuk batu ataupun temperature ataupun heat boleh shape silicon jadi glass. So everything to make a dent, of course, you tak boleh comfortable, it requires some pressure. So you kena ada enough pressure in anything you do, baru you boleh groom. So to me it's a recipe lah. So all this is a recipe for me. Alright, next. So pernah dengar tak pasal growth mindset? Anyone pernah dengar pasal growth mindset? Kalau tak pernah, I boleh explain. So growth mindset basically dia nak kata free spirit tak juga, tapi dia open lah, open minded. So dia ada contrast with to fixed mindset. So fixed mindset is a limiting. So dia selalu ada BS rule lah banyak. So for me, dulu I banyak percaya benda-benda. Kadang-kadang tu sebab kita percaya sebab orang lain bagi tahu kan. So lama-lama I started to challenge those things tau. So rupanya it doesn't have to be that way. You can shape your own way. You can shape your own workaround to achieve the similar result. So that's one of the things that I think very helpful lah for you to for growth personally ke, professionally ke, interpersonal ke, leadership ke. So when you have a growth mindset, everything is possible. So dia suka give up apa semua tu, kalau rasa suka apa please people pleasing apa semua tu, it's a fixed mindset lah. So you kena open, you kena I have several experience in my life that put me lowest point in my life, and then those kind of experience humble me at many levels lah. So those experience that made me accept my own flaws. So I know I'm a human. So I know as a human we all do have flaws. So we need to accept them. Tapi jangan just accept je, cuba improve lah. So and then we rebuild from there. Kalau you sedih tak apa, take time sedih and then bounce back lah later. So those are the things lah. So ini pun continuity pada tadi. I think you can see, boleh baca lah what's the difference between those two. So today it's an overview. Banyak benda kita sentuh kat sini, it's just an overview. Maybe from time to time kita boleh buat specific topic about this, and we can explore this together lah. So yeah, you can see here you kena start. You kena mindset itu kan betul lah. And then you need to believe that you can learn anything you want. So, for example, you not pick up satu benda kan. It doesn't have to, you need to enroll yourself to another degree, pergi course ke. So there's always alternative. You boleh belajar kat online, boleh belajar kat YouTube, boleh cari kawan belajar benda tu. You tak perlu kena ada duit, kena masuk universiti, kena ambil course, get the certificate, and then baru you tahu something. Tak perlu pun. So there is always another way. So itulah. So yeah. Siapa boleh beritahu apa benda ni? Alien looking objects. Apa dia?
Neuron.
Yes, neuron. Exactly. So neurons dalam ni, kalau ada belajar biologi ke science dulu, dia ada sinap, dia ada axon apa semua tu kan. And then if you ingat balik masa kita belajar tu, dia cakap the way we shape our memory is by connecting with another memory. So benda-benda macam ni lah yang buatkan you creative, you lebih be open, you be connected, you are more exposed lah. So bila neuron bersambung, so you getting smarter. So you imagine benda ni as a unit. Satu neuron tu satu unit knowledge. So when you connected to each other, you boleh nampak banyak benda. So you can overcome something, you can nampak the general overview, specific overview from different angle. So it's actually it helps for you to dalam banyak skills lah, problem solving, creativity and banyak lagi. What is this? Anyone can tell?
Pokok.
Betul. So this is a representation of a tree. So kat sini, what I'm trying to say, kita boleh ambil iktibar, we can model our brain ataupun our learning path like macam pokok lah. Kalau kat sini boleh nampak. Pokok pun ada anatomi dia. So dia ada trunk, batang pokok tu yang paling besar tu. They got branches. So dia ada multiple branches, kiri, kanan, atas, tepi apa semua tu kan. Lepas tu dia ada another branches, sub branches tu. And then last kali dia ada daun. And then kadang-kadang tu dia ada buah. Itulah. So yang kat bawah tu pula dia punya akar lah, the foundation. To make the tree stands, tahan apa semua yang untuk dia jadi subur dan hidup lah. So okay, kita boleh model our the learning patterns, the learning approach macam pokok juga. So tadi tu I mentioned trunks, batang pokok tu, you imagine this is a subject. So subject, and then setiap subject tu mesti dia ada subtopik dia. So dia mesti ada, dia ada a bigger idea lah. For example, kata baik tak bagi example lagi, jaga kita go detail. So lepas tu dia ada topik, and then subtopics. Lepas tu dia ada ideas. Betul kan? For example macam Aizat dia ambil mechanical. Dia belajar diploma dia mechanical je. Ha. Lepas tu bila dia go for higher degree, so dia belajar lagi specific. Ha. Lepas tu for example macam, macam Amani, Amani dulu dia maths degree. Lepas tu dia go more specific, dia buat research. And then macam Dr. Kambi, lama-lama dia makin specific, very niche. And then you study that very tiny areas je. You attack, 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 attack sampai dapat. Tapi the general vertical is so huge actually. And then sama macam ni juga, semua topik tu, for example macam if you pick up engineering, so you need to have a strong foundation about physics lah, mathematics lah, so science lah kan. So benda-benda macam tu lah. Okay, siapa boleh tahu siapa lelaki ni? Siapa betul yang boleh bagi RM10 right now? Tak tahu eh? Okay. Tak tahu eh? Okay, this guy is a very famous, it's a renowned physicist, American physicist, nama dia Richard Feynman. So dia physicist tapi dia juga philosopher. Ha? Dia
dekat Richard Feynman, betul lah tu.
Ya ke? Ya ke? Tak dengar bro.
Aku lagi McDonald
lah. Okay, nanti kita discuss over it. So Richard Feynman, selain daripada hasil kajian kerja dia dalam akademik, dalam sains apa semua kan, engineering, dia juga ada contribute to learn faster lah. So dia yang model guna pokok ni. So mungkin you don't know Richard Feynman sebab dia dah lama sangat kan. Dia dah tak ada dah. So maybe you know this guy. Siapa ni? Elon Musk. Yeah. Elon Musk pun, you know that guy is expert generalist, right? So dia belajar fizik tapi dia boleh conquer dalam automotif, dalam space engineering, dalam computer science, dalam business. And then the guy is very introvert. So dia tak belajar kat university pun. Dia pick up benda-benda macam ni lah. So dia tackle the big idea dulu. Lepas tu dia tengok, okay, dia nak tahu tak benda yang detail lah. So kalau dia tu, dia masuk lagi. And then dia pergi dalam lagi. Last kali, and then dia repeat kepada subtopik lain, another branches. And then last kali, memang dia expert in this area. So that's why dia suka tanya. Dia hire very smart person masuk dalam company. Orang tu ingat Elon Musk selalu tanya sebab dia nak test dia. Rupanya tak, dia nak belajar. Sampai dia perah orang tu sampai orang tu dah tak ada benda nak tanya dah. And then Elon Musk lari lah, dia pergi tempat lain lah. So tu lah. So I found this online. So I think it's a good representative for this. Dia panggil as a wisdom tree. Tadi ada mention pasal leaf, pasal trunks, pasal fruits. So fruits ni we can see this is the actual knowledge that you are looking for lah. And then kena ingat juga macam pokok. So kat luar sana banyak noise. So kat sini leaves, daun-daun ni is a good representation for distraction lah. So I think we can learn something from here. So ada falsafah. Okay, ni pokok tadi kan? Okay, kita boleh anggarkan, kita boleh ni tengok sebagai satu domain, for example, ataupun industri, computer science. Setiap orang, dia tak, passion dia, minat dia bukan satu, banyak. Maybe, for example, me, I do computer science. Tapi at the same time, I ada minat benda lain juga. I mungkin ada minat design sikit, ada explore, guna framework yang sama. Maybe I minat business. Maybe I minat engineering, maybe minat politik sikit, space, dan lain-lain lagi. So daripada situ, actually bila once you conquer satu-satu area tu, you boleh transfer the learning kepada tempat lain. Even dalam machine learning pun use the same principle. So dia katakan dia detect satu-satu benda kan, it's very good at detecting face for example, and then using the same model, so dia boleh apply ke tempat lain. So it's very good at detection tau. So dia boleh apply dekat, maybe detect objects pula, maybe detect kereta. So all those kind of things, I think it's help. So the same skills, when you dah acquire satu skills dalam bidang, just you nak pergi second vertical ataupun second industry or second top second the idea is relatively easy compared the first one. Sebab you dah ada experience kan. So itulah. So I love this image. So this is from Elon Musk punya company, so OpenAI. So this is a graphical representation for neural network. So neural network, ni a bit insights lah. Neural network is model after brain, our brain. So dia detect patterns, detect macam-macam lah, classify itulah ni apalah kan. So daripada situ jadilah benda ni. So I love this because I think untuk keluarkan satu gambar ni untuk render tu tak ada masalah, tapi it require 50-40 years of research of work that accumulated since the past 5 decades baru boleh dapat gambar ni. So dia dah habis thousands of hours, thousands of researchers mind to grow the knowledge, and then memang countless of funding required lah. So baru dapat satu gambar ni. So to me, kalau letak museum ni, I think banyak benda boleh fikir, and then to me I can take a lot of iktibar lah, and then ada motivation behind the picture. I'm not sure about you, maybe we can talk about this later one day ke. So let me, kita dah cover banyak area kan, so the construction about skills lah apa semua kan. So to me, skills adalah deliberate practice. So before it becomes skills, you kena practice, you kena repeat banyak kali, you need to learn, buat mistake, and then you try to correct your mistake, and then supaya tak ulang balik, and then later bila you dah buat banyak kali, you become good at it, and after you become good at it, you become expert at that. So benda tu memang require deliberate practice. So there's no shortcut, but to achieve this, you boleh combine dengan beberapa method approach tadi, Pareto apa semua kan. Tak payah cover the whole ground untuk cover tackle satu-satu benda. So if you remember, I've mentioned this a few times. So to acquire any complex topic, any new topic, any new ideas ataupun knowledge, to me it just take 20 hours untuk tackle. It's not being expert. Kalau kita tahu satu this one saying, dia cakap to become an expert you need to invest 10,000 hours baru boleh jadi expert. Siapa ada 10,000 hours? 10,000 hours is equivalent to 8 to 10 years full time punya commitment, full time job. So kita tak payah jadi expert, we just want to be good at something, and so kita boleh guna tu as a tool, as a knowledge to grow forward lah kan. So dalam video ni, nanti I share this slide, maybe at your own leisure you can watch this lah. I've watched this berbelas-belas kali. So every time I tengok pun I learn something new, walaupun video yang sama, bertahun-tahun tengok video sama. So basically dia distill kepada 4 simple method. So tadi kita dah cakap pasal this construction punya skill using Pareto rule. Lepas tu you learn enough to self-correct. Like I said, you make enough mistake, so you say you can belajar lah. You dah try cara pertama, cara kedua, cara ketiga salah, so takkan cuba cara ketiga lagi, at least you dah tahu cara ketiga tidak menguntungkan, so tak payah belajar cara ketiga. So when you cover enough ground, so you cover pretty much you have visit the whole platform lah. Lepas tu nombor 3 adalah remove practice barriers. I think few of audience today ada experience with me bila mana kalau dulu I think I can talk to Aizat lah. Aizat dulu, kalau if you remember, when you text me something, I don't promptly atau immediately respond to. Berapa hari?
Berapa hari mau respond?
Berapa hari ataupun tak pernah respond langsung kan? Because I remove the remove the distraction lah. Selalunya I was doing something, I tengah fokus masa tu. So masa tu I tutup, I buang barriers, all the notification, even phone pun tutup because it's distraction, so I can focus and deliberate practice kan. Kadang-kadang tu walaupun baca je that notification, but to me it's just information. So there's nothing I can ataupun it's not priority to act towards that information, so I just let it pass. So I think now we are working together, of course I need to pay you attention lah. So yang last number apa benda? Are you saying something?
Tak
boleh lah. So we are team now. Dulu pun kita menjadi team, tapi itulah when it comes to I need to prioritize stuff lah. Because I handle a few things at that time. So last kali deliberate practice lah. You practice at least 20 hours and then you decide. Should you continue this? Is this something that you really wanted to do? At least you dah test benda tu. You dah rasa lah. So kalau you dah ni, you carry on lah. Kalau if you decided to go deeper, nak guna tools ke, and then you carry on lah. For example, I think for this, the past few weeks, Amani, Koyung start pick up few software, few tools, remember? So I dah bagi few macam Robocop lah, GCP lah, Isra Amani study GCP. Tak pernah-pernah dengar GCP, kena baca pasal BigQuery, kena buat lab. Because we going to use that. And then lama-lama, you are not going to be expert yet. Tapi slowly you dapat, oh, macam ni cara nak guna. Faham tak? So lama-lama you boleh guna. You are getting proficient at that. So, slowly when you attack more time, you invest more time, of course I, eventually you become expert lah in that part. So itulah kalau ni I think today is a big revealing kenapa I suruh buat macam ni, kenapa I suruh buat homework. Kenapa tak suruh buat kerja terus? Kenapa kena baca ni, kenapa kena pergi Coursera ambil course ni? Kenapa I ada suggest a list of courses that you should take? So benda-benda macam ni lah, you attack the big topic dulu, lepas tu we go deeper and deeper. So I like this saying. So it says, here's to the crazy ones, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers, the round pegs and the square holes, the ones who think differently. They are not fond of rules. They have no respect to the status quo. You can quote them, disagree with them, glorify or vilify them. But about the things that you can do is ignore them, because they change things. They are earth movers. They make a dent to the universe. They push the human race forward. And while some may see them as a crazy one, we see geniuses. Because the people who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world are the ones who do. So I memang suka benda ni. The misfit, the rebels, the troublemakers. So I don't respect rules. I make my own rules. Even though the way I'm conducting the company pun, actually I don't run a company, I don't run a business. I run a cult here. Semalam I did share something dengan Koyum lah. Siapa boleh teka benda ni, siapa yang cakap, I give RM10. Give your best guess. Rasa-rasa siapa yang cakap ni? No, it's not coming for me. Siapa jap?
Elon,
bukan? Siapa-siapa? Dua lagi, dua teka lagi. Dr. Kambri, are you there?
I know who said it. I've heard of it, tapi tak tahu. Tak ingat siapa buat.
Ah, okay. Alright. Tak ada, no more guesses, mm-hmm. So, this is Apple punya founder lah, cakap Steve Jobs. So, if you study about him, you watch the documentary ke, you read his biography ke, autobiographical ke. So, you boleh tahu dia ni, he's a crazy one lah. So, the misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers. I suka cari orang yang karakter macam ni. Because dia akan hack their own way to achieve something rather than respecting rules yang macam orang lain dah buat. Sebab to me, many of the workaround out there, it works, but to me it's slow. So we need to be faster, and then bila dah faster, more faster. So yeah. And then since the past yang korang dah start join Melbourne, I selalu cakap pasal these three things kan. So learn, you need to learn fast, and then you need to unlearn fast, lepas tu relearn balik. So there's a reason why. So about I want you to grow lah. If you slow, you kena tinggal. In this industry, we doing consulting kan. We are reference to clients. So kalau kita tak boleh nak belajar cepat, dia orang nak request apa? And then kita kena tahu banyak benda lah. Mungkin kita tak tahu in detail, but it's fine. Everything is on the job training. So this is the framework lah. Macam yang tadi tu, learn, this is the framework. And then you need to unlearn, you kena ni. And then that's how you grow lah. So there's a one saying from Alvin Toffler. I'm not sure who's the guy, but he said, "The illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who can learn, unlearn, and relearn." So if you master this, insyaAllah you boleh pergi mana-mana. You are future proof. You're not affected by the technological changes, disrupted by certain industry. So sebab you grow all the time. So for me myself, I've seen myself evolve multiple times. I've shred my skin so many times. So I jatuh bangun balik. So that's benda tu biasa. That's how you grow lah. So by have a lot of scars, battle scars, some people say it. So I want to ask, what for your own understanding, what do you think? What is the difference between job, career, and calling? Anyone? Dia lebih kurang je. Career, kerja, calling, ataupun mission. Anyone? No? Job, kerja lah kan? Ataupun satu lagi, ada satu lagi, hobi. So, okay. Ada satu blog post ni, I kind of like it. So let me kita go through together. So this one. Hobby versus job versus career versus calling. So dalam ni dia ada beritahu. Okay, hobby benda yang we keep our life busy and interesting lah, fun. Typically hobby dia tak ada risk. Because we do it for fun, maybe we love to play games, maybe we love to music, dancing ke, whatever ke, reading ke kan. So it's something that you do that fulfilling. So lepas tu, job pula, typically job is transactional. So you trade your time and effort for money, that's why you having a job, so you can survive. A career pula is a job that you passionate. So this is another level lah. So selalunya kalau macam company dia bagi 5 benda. So orang yang having a career, dia selalu company dia cakap nak 10, tapi dia always over deliver. Kadang-kadang tu dia tak deliver pun, tapi dia belajar. Tak ada orang suruh pun, dia belajar sendiri apa semua kan. Lepas tu pula the highest level after hobby, job, career tu, this is the highest lah, which is a mission. Life mission. A calling. So bila you ada calling, you tak payah nak ni. So you akan cari benda tu sendiri. So benda ni take time to develop. And then tak semua orang ada benda sama. But then I just expose you. So there's ada peringkat-peringkat yang ni lah. So for me, I always say that I even though I do works, I selalu rasa macam I'm not doing any work. I'm having fun here. So selalu pun I selalu wish people having fun. I wish you have fun at your work. To them, mungkin dia orang not having fun, but to me, that's just the way I'm having fun. I don't have hobby. Everything that I do is basically is my hobby. So, so yeah, yep. Dia nampak sikit komputer. Buka banyak benda. Come on.
Oh, ingatkan Apple balik hang-hang juga.
Eh, saya buka banyak banyak benda je. Tak pernah tutup lagi. Since the past 2-3 months, I think. So, ini saya dah hide ni banyak benda.
Alamak.
Okay. So, next. Nak bedah, nak bedah. So, siapa kenal? Who is this guy? Satu character.
Dia lah hero dalam Avengers
tadi. Betul-betul, saya setuju. So, dia terkenal sebagai apa? Dia sebenarnya tak ada jahat pun. Dia ada wrong moral, dia ada different moral sikit lah. Dia ada different approach lah compared with ada individual groups kan. So, he believe something. And then, dia ada something yang ni lah, dia selalu cakap dekat, ada satu scene tu dalam Avengers Endgame, dia ada cakap kat Tony Stark, Iron Man. Dia cakap, you are not the one, you're not the only one who cursed with knowledge. So, benda tu deep lah. So, knowledge is power. So, with knowledge, with hard work, you can do wonders. So, itulah. So, last kali, I would like to repeat this. The misfits, the rebels, the troublemakers. So, those are three characteristics that I always look into. And then I think it's become part of my identity, and I would like to have part of everyone's identity as well, because I want everyone to grow. I want everyone to evolve. So by 6 months, 12 months down the line, I want to see Amani is different person now. I want to see Koyum is different person, Aizat pun sama, and then Ika pun sama, everyone, the whole company pun, kita akan evolve all the time. So at one point, we are no longer conducting a business. We are having fun here. We are making a dent to the universe. So that's my aspiration. So I think that's all for me. Thank you.